to take just a few minutes here and talk about the few buttons that we see down here at the bottom. We see edits, customer lookup, check, send, and pay. Now, I'm not going to talk much about customer lookup. Most people don't use this function in the quick serve restaurant industry. We'll talk about it later in another training session. Now, however, we do want to talk about the edits button real quick, which when we hit that button, it's going to bring us back here to really just a quick interface panel of sorts that allows us to perform several routine functions for the cashiers. So you'll see here we have void items, we have comps, discounts, apply gratuity, resend to kitchen in case the kitchen didn't get the order or they just need another copy for some reason, or void invoice. We can assign a guest number, we can split the check. You see there's quite a few features here. Don't be afraid to play with those if you have a particular need for one of those. Now when you're done using one of those features, this screen will typically go away all on its own, but if we want to click the close button just to go back, we can. Now, what do we do with the send, check, and pay? What this is set up to do is, in an event that you want to ring up items for transaction and you're not going to take money from the customer yet, then you could ring those items up and we can click send. And what that's going to do, it's going to put the transaction on hold for us. And the way we're currently set up, we would be able to assign the on hold ID. It might be somebody's name. It might be, in this case, we're just going to use something really simple and click enter. And it's going to make that order go away. It's going to put it on hold, fire off a kitchen ticket if there's a kitchen printer attached, and wait for you to call those back up and recall those on hold. All right, now once we've got that order put on hold, then we can ring up transactions from other customers, and then when we're ready to call that one back up and actually take payment, we can go, there's a couple of ways. We can set up a quick key, which we'll talk about later. For the moment, we're just going to click edits. We're going to go to options here, which brings us to our main control panel for the software, and normally that's going to default to the category number one, which is cashier settings, and then we're going to find letter E, which is recall on hold invoice. When we click that, it's going to show a list of existing on hold invoices. We can click and highlight our item from the screen. Then we're just going to click select here, and that's going to bring that item up, and it's going to show the little arrow marks next to the items that have already been fired off and sent to the kitchen. Now, we could add additional items if we wanted. If we want to do this kind of like a tab where they're in ordering at a bar or something like that, and they want to order, put it on hold, order again, put it on hold, and then pay at the end. At any rate, whenever they're ready to actually pay, we're just going to click the pay button, and that's going to take cash from the customer. And then we're done with the payment. Now, the check button here can be used in a scenario where you have a customer that does have either a tab or they're ordering at a table and you want to give them the ability to make those orders, fire them off to the kitchen printer, go back and forth, make a few rounds of orders, but then before they pay, you actually want to take a check to their table. So in that case, after we put the order on hold, we're just going to hit the check button, and that's going to generate a receipt check that we can take off to the customer. It's going to have a tip line on it. We can leave it with them, walk away until they're done. And then if we want to go back, we can pick that receipt up with gratuity assigned to it already and click a final pay and process that order through, kind of like we do for table service scenario, or kind of a hybrid bar tab scenario where we're taking orders but not necessarily paying right up front.